Hey, welcome back. This is Carlos Cavallo from datingadviceguru.com. What does FWB mean? Well, I know what it means, and you probably know what it means too. It means friends with benefits. But there's a bigger question here, and that's one you want to know. Are we more than friends? Hey, and before we get started right now, let's make sure to do the big three. What are they? Number one, make sure you subscribe. Number two, turn on those notifications so you know when my new videos come out. And number three, leave me your comments below. Ask me your questions. Tell me what you want to see in the next video. Yeah, the benefits of friends with benefits is that you can sleep with each other and get some intimate action as a side benefit, right? But is it really a benefit? Is that the relationship you really want with this guy? You might actually be wondering if you're in an FWB, friends with benefits, or are you his girlfriend? Is he your boyfriend? Well, first we should cover some signs that you're only friends with him. Are you more than friends? Sign number one is he keeps you as a secret. Now this might seem kind of cool in a forbidden love kind of way. I mean, you almost feel like you're doing something a little edgy and taboo, right? Until you don't. Which is to say that it gets old really quick. It gets old the second you discover that you have feelings for him and you wonder, does he have them for you? Or if you're just a friends with benefits and basically he's hiding you away like a dirty little secret. A lot of women start up a relationship with a guy only to discover that he's not posting anything about them online. He's not talking to his family about her, or he's not putting his full name on, or her full name on his phone, or meeting any of his friends. What's typically going on here is that he's either not ready to make your relationship public, or he just doesn't want to define it quite yet, or he only wants to be friends with benefits with you. Another sign is that he'll not be as affectionate in public if he's not feeling you two have relationship potential. Another way to say this is that he will be all over you like a cheap suit if he's really into you. Guys love to stake their claim to a woman, and men simply don't hold back on their public displays of affection unless he's not into a relationship with you. Just FWB, sign number two, he won't label your relationship. Simply put, he's not gonna let you declare the relationship as, well, anything. The second you ask, what are we, he's gonna start ducking, bobbing, weaving, sidestepping, you know, and dancing the tap dance of a lifetime. He might say, I don't like labels, or let's just play it casual, or a bunch of other things. The truth is that a lot of women will hear his excuse and immediately think he's commitment phobic. Nope, he's just not into you. Now I know that's a bitter pill to swallow, especially when he breaks it off with you or disappears only to resurface 3 days later with a girlfriend he can't keep his hands off of. Now you know what's happening when that happens. And you might even want to see my other video on where is this going, defining the relationship. Are you his girlfriend? Sign number three, you're not going out and you're not going anywhere. Well, this one shows up pretty quickly as an obvious situation of never leaving the house, right? You wind up staying home and just chilling and Netflix because he never wants to go anywhere. Well, there's a couple possibilities here. One is he's just a lazy homebody. I know about this one. I used to be one until I finally realized that it was costing me relationships. So I started to relax that need to stay inside. To be fair, I had a pretty cool apartment, you know, big screen TV, theater sound, comfy chairs, nice couch, nice cool dog, you know, relaxing location in Sausalito. Kind of makes me miss that. But yeah, he's got to get you outside the house. He could be cash poor. Not having any disposable income limits a man's options, and he's not going to be proud of that fact or want you to know. Number three, he's not into being seen with you. This one is usually connected to the whole doesn't want to define the relationship or even have one, okay? It's rare that a guy doesn't want to be seen with a woman because he thinks there's anything really horrible about her. He may just be avoiding running into anybody he knows or any women he's already dating. Number four, he's only in it for the convenient fun. And that usually means that he's not so into spending money on dates where takeout and a movie rental is gonna do instead. Okay, so now you know where he's coming from. Are you just FWB? Sign number four, it's all about the booty, baby. Well, one of the simplest ways you can spot an obvious FWB relationship is that he's only gonna call you when he wants to come over and get some. He'll show up late because he has no interest in hanging out, just the booty, ma'am. He'll avoid any kind of conversation that doesn't end with, so let's get naked. In fact, you'll notice that this kind of guy will also get a little bratty and selfish if you're not into having him sleep over. If he keeps steering the entire conversation or the date over to how soon you guys can get into bed, you know where you stand. Okay, now there's a far more important detail you're probably curious about. Are you more than friends? Or, well, does this relationship have the potential to be more than friends or friends with benefits? The answer is yes. It always does have potential to be more than that, but you have to be willing to reach out and apply some strategy. Now, a lot of women might hear that word and pull back, thinking, oh, that means you have to play games with them, head games. I get that a lot. I get a lot of emails saying, I don't want to play games. Well, here's the scoop on playing games with guys. You're already playing games right now. Let me put this into perspective for you. When a guy shows interest in you and he's somebody that you're interested in, what would you say to him when he asks you out? A, I don't know if you're my type. That's hard to get, by the way. B, what a surprise. Sure, we can. What would you have in mind? C, oh yes, look, I really like you. I'm so glad you're interested in me too. Can we go out tonight? Tonight, huh? Now, chances are you answered B. Now, why did you answer that one? Well, you realize that option A, I don't know if you're my type, that's the classic hard to get response. That's definitely game playing in a rather unhealthy way. Option C, oh yeah, look, I really like you. You know, that one is too much truth. You're spilling your guts and saying way too much. Even if it's all true, you'd never tell a guy that much before you got to know him in case you'd scare him off, right? So even though you know option C is the most truthful, you wouldn't use it. Huh, how about that? Which leaves option B as the most middle of the road response. It's the answer I would pick for you too. Why isn't option B game playing? After all, it's not entirely true. You're holding back some information. You're not really telling them how much you like them, right? You're not telling your whole feelings, which by the way is a lie of omission, but it's a safe white lie that won't hurt anybody. Well, you don't consider that game playing or being manipulative because you're being strategic with the information you reveal to him. It's all in an effort to play it slow and relaxed until you can both ease into your feelings for each other and eventually tell the whole truth about those feelings. Okay, technically, this is manipulation, that's game playing, but it's good and healthy, okay? It's a healthy form of game playing to help you both not freak each other out, and it gives you a chance to build up the romance between you. After all, what you don't know is good, at least at the start of a relationship. So the truth is that all interactions have a small amount of game playing in them. Some have a huge amount of game playing, sure. Human beings are, we're actually suspicious when people are too open and too honest with us. You know that, I know that, which is why we go along with certain games. So let's talk about the elephant in the room, attraction. Attraction is what brings us together, and that attraction is almost always starts out as sexual attraction. Yeah, that means you too. Attraction is about the driving need to couple up with somebody and fulfill one of our most powerful and primal drives, to procreate. Now, yeah, I know if there's other people out there that are different genders and different sexual attractions, that's all fine. But the primary function of sexual attraction is to get us to make more little versions of us. And just about every part of your body participates in this ritual too, from your hormones to the fine little hairs on your arm and neck. You're tuned into love in every way. Your body is built for it. Men know that a serious relationship requires work. So a man might not want a real full-scale relationship for a whole bunch of reasons. Because he's too busy to invest in a real relationship. Because he doesn't see himself here in this situation and this particular lifestyle for the long term. Because he's not happy where he's at and sex is a nice diversion. Because he's a single dad and his children are his priority. Because he's rebounding from a serious relationship. Because he might be kind of cheating with you. He's too hurt too much and just wants no complication sex without entanglement. Because he doesn't want to be monogamous as a lifestyle choice. A ton of reasons and all that stuff I mentioned before. And guys also realize that they're not as good at relationship stuff as you probably are. Men also know that relationships are messy and they often, actually frequently, don't work out. You either find your true love, you find someone that's good enough to stay with, but you know that you're settling, or you break up. That's really all the options there are. And that's huge, by the way. So let me share a few important truths with you about men and answering this question of whether or not you can be more than friends. Here's a truth. Casual sex tells a guy that you're not a serious girlfriend. Even if you are serious about having a serious relationship, jumping into bed quickly tells him you are more willing to give up your desire to wait than you were to hook up. When you put the sex first, he will put the relationship last. That's a little Carlos quote for you there, and that spells casual, C-A-S-U-A-L, to a guy in very clear terms. A lot of movies and books will tell you that FWB relationships can turn into love, but in the real world, it's actually pretty rare. I know you're feeling like you got ripped off by Hollywood and all those rom-com movies, and you're right, they didn't do you a service there. Guys don't see casual encounters as emotionally engaging. They see them as sexually relieving. Another Carlos quote there. A man has a strong natural physical drive to jump in bed with women because it's built into his body. His mind doesn't even have to participate. So if you let him, he'll shut that pesky brain right off and just have some fun. Here's another truth for you. In order for casual fun to turn into a relationship, he's got to see something that he really wants in you. Now this might seem like an obvious duh thing to say, but it's actually important to your dating life. A lot of women I work with and coach are very eager to stand out from other women. They ask me things like, what perfume should I wear? What clothes do men like? Should she act more sensual or sexual? Should she lift up his ego more? What should she say to him that will make him pay attention to her? Now all these questions, they're all important, but they're only important if you don't understand men. Sure, you could wear a really expensive perfume, but if you don't know how to talk to him, he won't care about the perfume. Sure, you could wear an expensive dress and shoes, but if you don't know why he listens to some women and why he immediately dismisses other women, you're going to be lost. Sure, you could polish up his ego with flattery, but if you don't understand what a man needs more than superficial ego strokes, he'll lose interest on the first date with you. You see, people have a way of focusing on those things that make the least difference in how men really look at them. Everything on the outside should be attended to, of course, do that stuff. But the real thing you have to know is why a guy chooses one woman over another. Let's be really clear about this. Nothing else matters. You got to know why he chooses one woman instead of another. Because if you understand that, what men are looking for, the outside stuff simply doesn't matter. You can always get a guy to be more than friends, but it starts with understanding how men work, how we think, why we think that way. Without that skill, you'll never have a quality relationship with him. You'll always be uneasy. You'll always be worried about whether or not you'll be able to keep him attracted, what you have to do next. You'll think about cosmetic surgery, implants, makeup, fashion choices until you die. And I don't want that for you. The women that really understand men can attract guys at any age. It doesn't matter how many extra pounds she has. It doesn't matter if she's not a runway model. It doesn't matter if she's not the smartest, sharpest knife in the drawer. None of that matters. Women who get their soulmate know how to keep him locked in and wanting her forever. Now, I got a free little gift for you down here that'll help you get started on that path. It's absolutely free. Go to datingadviceguru.com/free. That's datingadviceguru.com/free to pick up my free ebook and chapter from one of my programs. It's going to help you. It's going to help fill in the blanks and show you how men think and why we make the choices we do. This is Carlos Cavallo from Dating Advice Guru. Make sure you do the big three, right? Number one, make sure you subscribe. Two, turn on those notifications so that you know when the next one comes out. Next video is coming out easily within a week. And number three, don't forget to comment below. Make sure you tell me what you want to know. What do you want me to do the next video on? And as always, live and love with passion.